देखो क्वेश्चन, ए कंपनी हैज थ्री प्रोडक्शन फैसिलिटीज S1, S2 एंड S3 विथ प्रोडक्शन कैपेसिटीज ऑफ 7, 9 एंड 18 यूनिट्स इन हंड्रेड्स पर वीक ऑफ ए प्रोडक्ट रिस्पेक्टिवली। दीज यूनिट्स आर टू बी शिप्ड टू फोर वेयर हाउसेज D1, D2, D3 एंड D4 विथ रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ 5, 8, 7 एंड 14 यूनिट्स इन 100 पर वीक रिस्पेक्टिवली। द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कॉस्ट इन रुपीज पर यूनिट बिटवीन फैक्ट्रीज टू वेयर हाउसेज आर गिवेन इन द टेबल बिलो। सी द टेबल, और द टेबल इज मिसिंग। लेट मी गिव यू द टेबल फर्स्ट। On the table first, see here, okay. Okay, so now see the table. This is your table, and formulate this transportation problem as an LP model to minimize the total transportation cost by NWC method. See here the table, D1, D2, D3, D4, there are four columns or four destinations. S1, S2, S3, there are three rows or three factories. These are vertical or warehouses. This is your supply and this is your demand, or this is your availability and this is your requirement. You need to formulate this problem, and so that you can minimize the total transportation cost by NWC method. So you can do it yourself as our earlier problem. No need to go here. Next, we come to our next method. The first method is NWC method, and the second method is least cost method or matrix minimum method. See here, step one, this is your algorithm. Allocate as much as possible to the lowest cost cell, and then eliminate that related row or column that has been exhausted. It means we need to search for the cell having lowest cost. Second, if both row and column exhausted, then strike off either a row or a column. In case more than two cells with lowest cost, select the cell that can have maximum allocation. Step two, repeat this procedure for the remaining cells. Example, go through the earlier problem. You can solve earlier problem using this technique. One problem is solved here for your reference. Describe the method of matrix minima and solve the transportation problem. See here, these are our five destinations, D1, D2, D3, D4, and D5. This is your supply 8, 10, 12, and this is your three origins, O1, O2, and O3, and this is your demand 4, 4, 6, 8, 8. See here this solution. Here summation AI means 8 plus 10 plus 12 is 30, and summation BI is 4 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 8 is also 30. So this requirement is satisfied. Next, we need to make search here for the cell having the minimum cost. So the cell having the lowest cost is this one, means 2, 5, cell 2, 5. Here this is the cell with lowest cost, so we need to allocate here maximum possible. So maximum possible is either from 8 and 10, minimum of 8 and 10 is 8, So we can allocate at the maximum of 8 here. After this, the fifth column is exhausted. So we strike this column off. First allocation is made in the cell 2, 5 is equal to 8. The reduced cost matrix is as follows. See the reduced cost matrix. Okay. Now the reduced cost matrix will contain D1, D2, D3, D4. D5 is striked off earlier. O1, O2, O3. And the here cost are 8. Here it was 10. But now 10 minus 8 means 2. Remaining is unit is are 2. This is 12, 4, 4, 6, 8. Now look for the cost, the cell having the lowest cost. You can see there are three cells, 1, 2, 1, 4, and 2, 4. They are having lowest cost 2, 2, and 2. So we have cells 1, 2, 1, 4, and 2, 4 that have the same cost. But the cell 1, 4, see the cell 1, 2, 1, 2 can accommodate either 4, minimum of 4 and 8, so it can accommodate 2. And 1, 4 can allocate 8 and 8. Minimum of 8 and 8 is 8, it can accommodate it. And 2, this 2, 4 is 2, 4 can accommodate. Minimum of 2 and 8 is 2. So we need to search for the cell that can be allocated maximum. So the cell 1, 4 can be allocated maximum. It will be minimum of 8 and 8 means it will be 8. But the cell 1, 4 may accommodate maximum. Therefore, X14 is equal to 8. X14 means here it will be equal to 8. So strike off first row. So we just striked off first row. Then the reduced matrix, cost matrix will be as under D1, D2, D3, D4. O1 is not here, the first origin, O2 and O3. Remaining portions are the same, 2, 12. And here, we have 4, 4, 6, and here since 8 goes, so here we introduce epsilon, and here also epsilon, this epsilon will tend to 0 later on. After this, our reduced cost matrix will be like this. See here, X24 is equal to epsilon, where epsilon tends to 0, so this allocation will be 0. Next, see here, the minimum is the lowest cost cell is 4, 4. And here we can accommodate either 2 or minimum of 2 and 4 means 2. And here we can avoid minimum of 6 and 12, so 6. So we will select this cell, means 3, 3, X3, 3. Here we will allocate minimum of 6 and 12. So X3 is equal to minimum 6, 12, it is equal to 6. So after allocation, this third column is exhausted. So we will strike it off. So after striking that column, we will have only D1, D2, O2, O3, this 2, 4, 4, this is 6. Since earlier it was 12, but now after subtracting 6, we will get here 6. Now this is our lowest cost cell and it can accommodate minimum of 2 and 4. So X22 will be minimum 2, 4, 4 means it is 2. It means this row is exhausted. So eliminate this O2. Then the remaining cost matrix is D1, D2, O3, 6, 5. This here is 6, here it is 4. But after subtracting these two, this 4 becomes 2. So it is 2. Now this is our lowest cost cell. It can accommodate minimum of 2 and 6. So it can accommodate 2. So this column is stacked off, D2. So we will have only O1, D3, 6. And here it is 6 minus 2 means it is 4, 4. So X31, so here we will allocate X31 is equal to 4 units. Thus, X25, this is our summary, X25 is 8, X14 is 8, X24 is epsilon, X22 is 2, X33 is 6, X32 is 2, X31 is 4. Here also m plus n minus 1 is equal to 3 plus 5 minus 1, it is equal to 7. Since 3 row and 5 column, it is 7. But only 6 allocations, we have made only 6 allocations. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 and 6. This is our 0, so it will not be counted. So we have only 6 allocations, but there are m plus n minus 1 is equal to 7 cells should be there. So it means the solution is non-degenerate, not, but solution is degenerate. Therefore, we get a degenerate solution. Now the transportation cost is calculated as 8 into 1 plus 8 into 2. 8 means this one plus 8 means this one into 2 plus epsilon into 2 plus 2 into 4 plus 6 into 4 plus 2 into 5 plus 4 into 6. It is equal to this one. So this is equal to 90 since epsilon is tending to 0. So allocations are multiplied with the corresponding values in the cell. So I think the example is clear. If you have any query, there is one more example. It is biometrics minima method. D1, just solve the TP by matrix minima or LCM method. This is our destination. This is our source. D1, D2, D3, D4, O1, O2, O3. This is our supply 7918. This is our demand 58714. So it is 34. It is our earlier example, which we have solved by northwest corner method. You need to solve it also by matrix minima method. This is the solution here given. You need to search first for the cell with the lowest cost. Yes. So it is not tough to solve this problem. This is our lowest cost cell 10 in the cell 32. In the cell 32. This is our lowest cost. Allocate here minimum of 8 and 18. So 8 is allocated here. Strike this column, strike off. Then the remaining, from the remaining part, the lowest cost is this, the 10. And so we allocate here minimum of 7 and 14. So 7. So 7 is allocated here. Similarly, proceeding in the same way, you can allocate all the cells. And here M plus and minus 1 is 6. And M plus and minus 1 should be 6 because 3 rows and 4 columns. So 3 plus 4 minus 1 means 6. So this is the solution will be non-degenerate one. So note down all of them. And if you have any difficulty or any query, ask me here.